Right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, hey, this is a backstroke sort of analysis for a presentation Mark Schubert's going to do. And I thought I'd go through some of these of my favorite backstrokers. I can't say that Chacon is my favorite backstroker, but I can say that he has the world record. So I have him here in a flume, which isn't terribly favorable to him, perhaps, but. He's hauling here, and I think we're going to see that he is beatable. We have Ryan Murphy here, who does beat him at the World Championships a couple months ago. We have Regan Smith down here, who has both won and lost her backstroke at various times. And I think, and then we have my favorite backstroker of all time, Christina Eggerszegi. And very different types of backstrokers, different sizes, different heights. Different attitudes, different training modalities in some ways. So let's get to it. Let's see. Trying to figure out who to look at first. Let's take a look at Chacon first and see if you're trying to race Chacon, you probably don't want him to see this video because what we're going to see here is, again, he's in a flume, so water's shooting at him at a constant rate. So we're just going to watch this. Let's watch it at full speed. Now, if you're me, you can see this hitch. I work on this stuff all the time, but there was a hitch in his stroke. Let's go back and see it at frame by frame. So he's going here, and look at his left arm go in there, and watch his right arm go there. See that? Right at the beginning here, he hits like this. We're working with David Johnston right now, 400 IMer at the swim team. And he's doing exactly the same thing. So I almost don't want him to see this. And so Chacon now grabs the water and he pulls it. And his left arm seems to get it right away. See that? There's almost no pause there. And then same thing, he's upside down and then he's forward. So, but Chacon is really fast. And sometimes you just gotta go fast, whether you've got a stroke error or not. If he can't do it fast, maybe he shouldn't change it. But that's what I would change anyway. So let's just kind of keep an idea on that. Was he again? Was you see him coming in here with a? Well, he's stopping there, but just get the idea. Now we can roll that while everybody else goes, but let's not take your eye off the ball. Then let's go to Regan. Regan has at various times held the world record in backstroke. Really good flyer too. I like how she rotates her body really well. She pushes herself into rotation, especially on the left side. Really great rotation. We're seeing her whole back here. So those of you who are either beginners or have never seen yourself underwater, which is a shame. To me, any coach that doesn't require his swimmers to get video underwater at least once a week really is kind of a fitness class. That's just, I'm going to be opinionated here. I publish a magazine for that reason, so I can have an opinion. So here we go. So again, you see her coming off the dolphin kick, her first stroke, pushes in here, pushes her to the side, probably as well as anybody I've seen. A lot of people will take that first stroke and be really, really flat with it. Ryan does, you'll see it in a minute. See that? She's pushing herself to the side and she's ready to pull with her left hand immediately. And then she pulls with her right hand immediately. There was probably a little bit of an upside down there. See that? As she entered, a little bit of that. And then she's putting into the stroke. It's very quick, but it's probably something she could fix. I don't think she's doing it nearly as much with the left hand. Pushes herself into the position, and then she goes. It's a little flat at the beginning. Flat would be fine. It's when it's upside down like this that that's probably causing her a little bit of a rhythm problem. If it's not slowing her down, there's a rhythm challenge there. So she comes through here. She's going side to side. And then we can just see her go through the rest of the race. From the top of the water, it looks like just unbeatable. And which at various times she is. Let's take a look at Murph and see what he looks like. So he's away from us, and you're going to see the finish here. Chacon is winning this race here. And let's see if he looks the same as he did. Yep, see that? See that right hand go in like this, upside down. Then he grabs it, then he rotates. Then he pulls. So when Dr. Gennadius Sokolovas says that it's possible that we could go 3 seconds faster per 100, you may be seeing that that's true here. And he says that's just true in terms of biomechanics, that if we kept the training the same, that we would probably have 3 seconds per 100. And I can kind of see that. Now look at Murphy, though. He's better. Watch his left arm go in. He's here. Watch his left arm go in here, nice and ready to pull. There's no extra stuff at the beginning. Now he's pushing himself to the right side, grabbing the water, pushing himself to the left side, grabbing the water. Whereas Chacon is flat and bent, then he turns it around and then he goes. You guys all see that? All right, so hopefully you're seeing what I'm seeing. See the hand is upside down. Watch Murph again. Hands ready to pull. Hands ready to pull, and he pulls. And he pulls, and he pulls himself into a win here at the World Championships in 2023. Be interesting to see what they do. So that was just a difference of stroke. I don't know that it was a difference of turnover or anything else, legs, anything else. I think just Murphy has a better stroke there. Speaking of a better stroke, let's watch Christina Eggersegge as she pushes herself to rotation immediately into the next stroke. Same thing, push yourself in rotation immediately in the next stroke. You don't see anything upside down. Everything just falls into the next one right here from here to there. The finest backstroker I've ever seen in male or female. She's smooth and she's perfect. She didn't know to dolphin kick much back then. You gotta remember she went 206 in a swimsuit. Not in these suits that the girls are able to wear right now. So 206 is pretty good. I think the fastest now is 203. And her finish was back then, for back then, that was a really good finish. We didn't know to do that much. I don't think you were allowed to fully submerge back then, so that might have been DQable. But yeah, I think we could spend hours and hours looking at Christina, and I would love to do that. So let's see if we have any more underwater of her in this one. Yeah, I think we do. Hold on. So here she is coming this direction, right into the next stroke. Unfortunately, we don't have enough of her underwater. I don't think you can have enough of Christina Eggersegge underwater. Let's just try to see if we can get some more out of it by slowing it down. See how she's pushing water backwards the entire time? Not a bubble on her hand, pushing all the way through. Hips are right on top of the water, beautifully on top of the water. They used to call her the mouse. She was pretty small. Notice how that hand's entering, ready to go, and then turns it and pushes it through. Rand's ready to go, turns it, pushes ready through. This is a model backstroker. Very consistent. Head's a little bit high here, but for her height, it seemed to work. And I would probably get it back a little bit. And see, that finish is really good there. Yep. All right. This is backstroke from my point of view. I'm Steve Friederang. I'm the publisher of Competitive Swimmer magazine, and I could be deadly wrong about all this stuff. If I am, email me at steve@competitiveswimmer.com. Please, please, please subscribe to my magazine membership, where you're going to get things that you agree with and things that you don't, but you're going to be able to put your own 2 cents worth in if you subscribe. That's it, competitive.